What's going on, everyone? I'm Sir James from GamerFusion.com, and I'm here to give you my first impressions on a game called Rising Storm. Now, Rising Storm is a first-person shooter-based game with a World War II theme to it, where one side plays as the Axis and the other side plays as the Allies, which is actually pretty cool. Another thing, too, to note is that this game is only multiplayer-based, meaning there's no type of story mode or single-player aspect. There is a training mode where you're able to go in and pretty much learn the basics of controlling your unit, how to play as each of the class, you know, basically learning how to play your role and how to complete each of the objective types that are, you know, featured in the game, which is really nice, especially for new beginners or people who are new to this type of game or never played a first-person shooter game. It really does have a nice supportive training mode to actually teach you what you need to learn for this game. Now let me go ahead and jump in the gameplay and so forth. Now let me go ahead and just talk about the maps. There's a few different maps that were in the beta, which is actually pretty cool. It's not just like the same map over and over again. There's been maps where you've been fighting on the beachfront, over in the deep forest, in the deserts with these abandoned buildings and so forth. And you know, basically the level of detail in the game fits the need, basically fits the detail what this game is. Like I said, it has a World War II theme to it, where you're playing as Axis or Allies, and it you know, totally fits within the game, which is really cool. And even the music in the game fit. It kind of reminds me of, you know, parts of Pearl Harbor and other elements from maybe Medal of Honor, and just, you know, pretty much anything they expect from a military, you know, movie or show that you might have heard is actually featured in this game, which is really cool. Now in this game, what I do like is that depending on what unit you're playing as, you actually feel like you're playing as that role. I mean, you feel you're that role. So for example, you know, there's riflemen, assaults, machine gunners, snipers, light machine gunners, squad leaders, and commander. When you're playing as the commander, you feel like you're the commander. You could issue orders to the entire, pretty much everyone on your team. Because like I said, you're the commander, you're the main guy in charge. Of course, as the commander, you have additional abilities. For example, you're able to call in airstrikes or artillery shells and so forth, which is actually pretty cool. Like I said, if you're playing as the commander, you feel like the commander. If you're playing as the squad leader, you feel like you are the squad leader, issuing commands to the people in your squad, which is really cool. Like I said, so far, like if you're playing a sniper, you feel like you're the sniper. So pretty much any role you pick in the game, you play as that role, you do your job, and then the game is going to go great for you, because this game does require a lot of teamwork. It's not a typical run and gun. Some people were saying this is like Call of Duty. It's not. It's nothing like Call of Duty. You could kind of resemble it to Battlefield a little bit, but not to that extent. This game requires much more strategy. Like I said, it's not a typical run and gun. And of course, depending on where you get hit in the game in terms of taking hits, it's actually going to affect certain aspects. So if, like I said, if you get shot in the head, of course you're going to be dead. If you get shot in the heart, of course you're going to be dead. If you get shot anything where it's going to be lethal, you are going to be dead. If you get shot in the non-lethal area, you will start to bleed to death unless you bandage yourself up, which is a really nice game mechanic that I like how they put in there. Of course, you are able to crouch and crawl in the game. When you're crawling, of course, your unit's going to be much more slower, but you're going to have much more steady aim when you're taking your shots as well. Now, of course, depending on the map you choose will determine how many units can be played as. So, for example, in terms of the gameplay you're watching, in this one, there could be a total of 27 riflemen, 4 assault class, 1 machine gunner, 1 sniper, 4 light machine gunners, 3 squad leaders, and of course 1 commander as well. And of course, depending on what map you're on, that aspect always changes around. Of course, each class, such as the Axis and of course the Allies, have their own unique units as well. So for example, the Allies have access to a flamethrower unit, which is pretty cool. And of course, both sides also have access to a motor crew as well, where you're able to launch artillery shells to provide a supportive role, which is really cool. Now, the flamethrower unit, to be honest, is a really cool character. And I like how that, you know, because like I said, this game does feel like it has a realistic tone to it in terms of gameplay, what's supposed to be. And of course, the game mode that I've been playing in the beta, that's currently the only mode people are playing, is a realistic mode to give it to, you know, that real feeling that, you know, most people like in a shooter's game. Now, you know, when someone's playing as the flamethrower class, if you shoot their tank in the back, they'll actually explode and you'll kill that person, which is really cool. I mean, in real life, if I see someone carrying a flamethrower and they have a big tank, if I shoot that tank, I expect it to blow up, right? Well, in the game, that's exactly what happens. And of course, the flamethrower itself, when you're using it, has a pretty good range. You're able to burn units to death, which is actually really cool. And what I do like is that you're actually able to burn the environments. The environments will start, you know, setting a flame for a short amount of time, which is really cool. So let's say someone's hiding in the brush, but your flamethrower doesn't reach to it, so you could go ahead and just burn the brush, and then, you know, you're gonna see the flame slowly reach that unit that's currently hiding in the brush, and they're gonna die from the flames, which is really cool. So you do have, you know, a unique advantage to that specific unit depending on what you're playing as. Of course, like I said, each unit, you know, some will have secondary weapons and some will have, you know, equipment as well, which is indicated on the character screen. Now, you know, when you start off the game, you have to choose quickly what you want to be. For example, the sniper class, squad leaders, and commanders are the main units that everyone chooses right off the bat, because like I said, there's a limited quantity in terms of what you're able to play as. And of course, every time you die, you're able to change your role as long as that unit is available to choose on the character screen, which is really nice. So for example, if you're playing as the rifleman, you keep dying, maybe the rifleman's not working for you, you can choose another role to play as long as it's available. So for example, let's say if I'm playing as a rifleman, but I choose to change that, and the only role that was available is maybe a squad leader or a sniper, then you could choose to play as that role until another one is available. Because, you know, people might end up leaving the game or whatever the case may be. Which is really cool. And of course, it does have a nice cover system where you go behind cover, you push a key, your character goes behind cover. Now, it doesn't go into like a third person view or anything like that. You're just able to kind of peek over cover and take your specific shots if you're playing as the sniper. And of course, you're zoomed in with any type of scoped weapon. You do have to hold shift if you want to get a nice, basically your character will hold, you know, his or her breath in to take that steady shot and all that fun stuff. Like I said, it does really have a nice, unique, realistic feel in terms of this game, which is really like, which is what I really like. And like I said, this game is really pretty much teamwork based. So, you know, from what I've played so far, almost everyone has some type of headset, or people are currently using TeamSpeak, whatever the case may be. But this game does have an in-game chat support, so you're going to have people with different languages in the game, which is alright, because in the end, at least from what I've played, everyone seemed to understand what was going on and working together. And the way these people talk, I swear, I feel like most of these people that I played with, you know, have actually been on the battlefield, the way they speak. It's actually really cool, so it really immerses you into the game, which is what I really like. And so far, in terms of the community itself, at least the people I've played, no one's been using harassment or anything like that. Everyone's working as a team. And what I've also seen too for newcomers, that I've seen groups of people actually taking the newcomers around and teaching them what they need to learn in the game. So the community in this game is really strong, and one that I do appreciate, because, you know, sometimes you're going to get games where you're not going to have a great community, or you're going to have games that are going to have great community. In a game like this, I do see a great community where people working together, teaching the newcomers and so forth. And like I said, the World War II theme, the music, and the overall feel of the game is really cool. It's definitely well worth checking out. Like I said, it's only a multiplayer based game. World War II theme, in terms of maximum players, I know it goes up to past 40. I'm not sure the maximum amount, but you do have a lot of players on the battlefield. You're not going to have like a low amount, like only 20 people or so forth. You do have a lot of people on the battlefield. But like I said, this game is called Rising Storm. It's set to release, I think, here soon. Like I said, this is currently in beta phase. I know improvements will still be going on into the game, but from what I played so far, it's actually really cool. I really like it, and the game is actually working and all that fun stuff. So anyways, that was my first impressions of Rising Storm. What do you guys think? Is this a game that you guys are gonna check out as well? But anyways, I'm Sir James from Gamer Fusion, and remember, Gamer Fusion empowers your gaming.